Hello, everybody. I'm Dorothy Morgan. Thank you for joining me here today. We're going to talk about the astrology for April 2nd, and then we're going to use the astro dice. We've been using this for a while. We've been doing a daily forecast for quite a few months now. Then we're going to use a card from this deck. So we're going to give you the astrology for right now, and let's go ahead and share the screen. And let's take a look at what is our focus for today. And today is April 10th. All right. The astrology of today is, let's see, we've got quite a few things. You know, the main thing that I can see here, besides, you know, the big one, is, which Jupiter and Neptune are coming into their conjunction. They're just about exact now. Same thing in their declination over here. So they're very much one, right? Jupiter in Pisces, it's original rulership, its natural rulership. It rules Sagittarius too. But before we knew Neptune was around, Jupiter was in charge of Pisces. So now Jupiter and Neptune conjunct in Pisces is definitely globally giving us that major focus on compassion and understanding and, you know, helping in a big, big way. And that is especially because of all the different wars going on around the world. And we have one that's a major focus. But let's focus on something else here today, too. I want us to, what do we want to focus on for today? Today's a Christian holiday, so it's Palm Sunday. So a lot of people will be together with family and associates that, you know, that share beliefs. And it's quite unique. Well, not that unique, but Mercury is at the very end of Pisces, very end of Aries. And let me tell you, anytime anything right now for the next year or two is at the very end of the zodiac sign, first off, when a planet's at the end of a zodiac sign, it's just like that, that rush to get out the door when you're going, when you have an appointment and everything is like making you feel like you're late. So that's what, when things are at the final degree. Right. And we have Mercury today at the final degree of Aries. So we're feeling that rush, in a sense, to say something, to speak up. Ooh, might not be such a great idea because it is making a square aspect to Pluto. And what I was starting to say there, and I went off on one other thing. Anytime a planet is at the final couple degrees of every zodiac sign, it's going to be making an aspect to Pluto. So Pluto being at the very end of Capricorn, and he'll be that way, he'll peek into Aquarius in another year and a half, 2 years, but he's just constantly having an influence on all of the planets as they get to the very end of the sign they happen to be transiting through. So I know that's deep astrology. What does that mean, mundane? What does that mean for you, right? It means pay attention. If you can watch here. I'll always tell you about it, but pay attention to when planets are changing signs and just know that there is this very deep internal process that is helping us to change the way we communicate. That's today's, because Mercury's at 29 Aries. It moves into Taurus late in the evening. Here on the East Coast, it's 10:09 PM. So all day on Sunday, April 10th, Mercury at 28, 29 degrees of Aries is going to be feeling the intensity of that shift. Like, I really need to speak up. And again, it is in a square aspect to Pluto. So that creates a very profound changes. So we need to be very aware of our words at this point in time. And we can listen deeply. And we can go into our own meditations or into our own space and process, you know, what's important for you very deeply. That's the Pluto component of Mercury at the final degree of Aries. Mercury thoughts, processes, communication, squaring Pluto in Capricorn, which is what are my deep beliefs or those deep words. Are you spinning words in your head about you having a scenario that you're just making things up? Honestly, ask yourself that question. So I wanted to leave us with that. Always, always lots more on my Patreon. Please come and support me there. We're going to do the astro dice now. Now's the time you ask a question for yourself, you know, because this is the piece that's, you know, timeless whenever you happen to see this, right? Yep. All right. So Venus in Libra in the fourth house. Oh, isn't that's really nice. I was thinking of going and visiting my mother today. That's really nice. My sister's down there too, both whom are Libras. Fourth house is home. So, you know, I guess I'm going to go visit my mom and my sister. I'm now a half hour away from where I used to be. So I have to plan things these days. Can't just pop over anymore, but hey, well worth it. Venus, what we love in Libra, that's its rulership. So Venus, this is all about loving relationships or our relationships. With that Mercury Pluto square, even if we're in a loving relationship, we could still be really, it could be really difficult with our words. So please be impeccable with your words today. You know, just like I think I mentioned that yesterday too. But Venus in Libra, relationship, fourth house, home, family, somebody you care for deeply. This is just a nice, easy do it. If you're thinking of connecting with somebody today, even though maybe you're connecting because some hard words were said and you need to apologize, or you just need to clarify, whatever it is, Venus, Libra, fourth house. I like that. That is a beautiful energy for today, which is Palm Sunday and I don't know, what are the holidays? I apologize. I can't keep track of all of them. If it's in my calendar, I will talk about it. You know, and you guys can support me here, right here on YouTube. You don't have to go and, well, you can go and, you know, this is my profession. I've been doing this for decades. That's not a 6 month, I got a certificate and I'm a professional astrologer. I've been studying since 1988. It's been my full-time profession for over 20 years. Support me here on YouTube by just thumbs up and commenting below. And if you have groups that love astrology, share this link with them. That's how you can help. I appreciate it. Don't forget, book a session sometime. Today we got Dream Traveler. I think we got that just a couple days ago. Dream Traveler is beautiful. So work with your dreams. And before you go to sleep, write down what you would like. It's telling us again. So clearly I haven't done it yet. Lots of times this is my routine in the morning. Now you guys know exactly what I do too. I share it with you because these readings are just for me as well. The astrology, I like to, evaluate the day. Back to this. Oh my gosh, I'm all over the place today. That's Mercury at 29 Aries. I feel like I'm all over the place. My Jupiter is 29 Sag. So I have a trine aspect between my Mercury and my Jupiter today. And so fire trine, and it's like very dynamic. Dream traveler. So take some time and work with your dreams. All right. Find a way to do that. I mean, I saw some stuff come through on Facebook the other day about some classes and working with dreams. Susan Morgan, she's not a relative. We do have the same last name. She's out in Las Vegas now. And she does a lot of work with that. You can look her up if you want to know who she is. Let me know. I can send you her link. Work with your dreams. So before you go to bed, you can write down what it is that you want an answer to or some insight from. And in a couple of days, it usually works within a couple of days if you've never done it before. Work with your dreams, lucid dreaming, go to sleep thinking it's like, yeah, I want to work with my dreams tonight. I want to just see and explore, right? And, and allow that flow to happen. Allow that flow to happen too. All right, everybody, have a great Sunday, and I will see you tomorrow. So blessings and namaste.